I welcome you for the presentation on Power Plant Engineering. Myself, M.J. Murali, Associate Professor in the Department of EEE, working in Prince Sri Venkateshwara Padmavathi Engineering College. So in this presentation, we are going to see some types of power plants and their applications, and how these power plants will be useful for the technical education of the students. So first we will be seeing about the thermal power plant. So thermal power plant is nothing but the coal power plant, or we can say it as the steam power plant. So this is the basic type of power plant which is more simple in construction as well as in application side. So in this presentation we are going to see these contents, that is the introduction. That is how the steam is generated and what is the main application of thermal power plant. Next is the working principle, general layout of the thermal power plant, the main equipments involved, waste generated and air controlled, that is how the waste products are dissipated, advantages and disadvantages, and the last is the reference. So introduction, we will be seeing about what is the main meant by the thermal power plant. So it converts the heat energy of the coal. So coal is nothing but the raw material which is used for the production of electricity. So the thermal power plant, the heat energy of coal is converted into electrical energy, or we can say electrical power, by means of combustion of coal. Okay, so burning of coal is nothing but combustion. So by means of combustion of the coal, the heat energy will be converted into the electrical energy in association with the steam turbine. So the steam is expanded in the steam turbine, which produces the mechanical power. This mechanical power will be driving the alternator which is connected at the output side. So thermal power plants contribute maximum efficiency and generation of power. So it constitutes about 75.43% of the total installed capacitive power generation in India. So since this one is the basic power plant, most of the power generation will be taking place via the steam power plant. Okay. So in thermal generating stations, coal, oil, natural gas are employed as the primary sources of energy. So in the working principle, first we'll be considering about the boiler. So water is taken into the boiler from any type of water source, that is water resource. So from the water resource, the water is taken into the boiler, and a boiler is heated with the help of coal. So we are calling this one as coal combustion. So the water inside the boiler is heated by means of combustion of coal. So the increase in temperature helps in the transformation of water into steam. So water is converted into steam by increasing the temperature. The steam generated in the boiler is then sent to the prime mover. So the prime mover we are using here is the steam turbine. So there are various types of steam turbines. So any basic type of or any basic model of steam turbine can be employed for this purpose. So a steam turbine will be having blades that rotate when high velocity steam flows across them. So because of the rotation of the blades, we are having the generation of electricity, that is the mechanical force or the mechanical energy is converted into some type of electrical power. Generator is connected to the steam turbine, that is you are connecting the generator coupled with the prime mover. So prime mover is nothing but the steam turbine, you are connecting the generator to the steam turbine. So generator will be generating the required amount of power as per the requirement. So when the turbine turns, electricity is generated and given as output to the generator. So from the generator, the generated power will be given to the consumers. So this is the general layout of the thermal power plant. So where you can see the prime components involved in the construction. So now we are having the boiler. So we are having the boiler, steam turbine, condenser and economizer. So the main purpose of this economizer is to have the superheating of the steam. Okay. So the steam can be superheated by means of a economizer. So it will be acting as a type of a superheater. And you are having the additional accessories like the ash handling and the air preheater. So air preheater is also will be a type of a superheater for superheating the air coming from the coming it getting into the boiler. So boiler will be connected to the turbine. So turbine is nothing but the steam turbine where the expansion of the steam will be taking place. Turbine will be coupled to the alternator, and from the alternator you will be having the three phase supply as the output. And one part is nothing but the condenser where the steam is condensed and sent to the cooling tower, and this process becomes a cyclic one. And the condensate is given to the again to the economizer by means of the condensate water pump. In the economizer, again the steam is superheated and given to the boiler. Next. So the main components are cold handling unit. That is nothing but the main major raw material used is nothing but the cold. Okay. So for the cleaning of the cold and for giving the cold to the turbine, you are going for the cold handling plant. So by means of conveyor belts, these colds are given to the cold handling plant. Pulverizing plant, boiler, steam turbine, condenser, cooling tower, feed water heater, economizer and air preheater. So boiler, turbine, condenser and economizer, we are considering it as the major components. So in the cold handling plant, the coal is transported to the power station by means of a rail or load, that is depending upon the location, and stored in the cold storage plant, and it is then pulverized. The function of this plant is automatic feeding of the raw material, that is coal, into the boiler furnace. So normally you will be going for the conveyor belts where the coal is fed, and the coal will be transported to the corresponding boiler furnace. Thermal power plant burns enormous amount of coal. So the main criteria is that the coal must be abundant in that location. So where you are going for the construction of the steam power plant. That is, the raw material or the coal must be available in plenty. So the site selection for the thermal power plant or steam power plant is more important. So depending upon the availability of the coal. 200 megawatts plant may require around 2000 tons of coal daily. Okay. So as I told, wherever you are having abundant amount of coal, so that site can be selected for the construction of a coal power plant. So pulverizing plant. So in most of the modern thermal power station, the coal is pulverized. That is, it is crushed into a dust size material so that it can be fed easily to the boiler furnace in a stream of hot air. Okay. So this coal is first of all shipped and it is given to the furnace in a pulverized way. So it is a means of exposing a large surface area to the action of oxygen, and it will be helping in increasing the combustion process of the coal. Okay. So mainly you are going for the pulverizing plant for instant or rapid combustion of coal. Okay. By means of heated oxygen. So pulverizing process consists of three stages, that is feeding, drying and grinding, because you can't use the wet coal for effective combustion. So the coal must be a heated coal or it should be in the dry condition. So first the coal is fed into the furnace, the coal must be dried off without any moisture. The coal must be free from any type of moisture or we can say water content. Last you will be having the grinding of the coal in very minute particles so that it can be easy for the combustion to take place. So boiler. So the function of the boiler is the generation of steam by means of a combustion process. Okay. So by burning of the fuel in the furnace, we can say the water in the boiler is converted into the steam. Okay. So boiler is used for conversion of the water vapor or conversion of water into the steam. So turbine, three types of turbines can be used in order to increase the efficiency of the steam power plant. High pressure turbine, intermediate pressure turbine and low pressure turbine. So depending upon the cost of the thermal power plant, these turbines can be employed. Okay. Condenser. So normally you are going for a surface condenser which is used as a heat exchanger. Okay, where the cooling water flows through the horizontal tubes placed inside the condenser, and the exhaust steam fed to the shell surrounds the tubes. Okay. As a result, the steam condensate outside the tubes. Okay. So condense from the turbine, the condensate is collected in the condenser. Next. cooling tower. So condenser needs huge amount of water in order to condensate the steam completely. So in order to aid this process, you are going for an additional cooling tower in associated with the condenser. Most plant used cooling system where warm water flowing from the condenser is cooled and it can be reused. Cooling tower is here can be made up of steel or it can be made up of concrete at a height of 150 meters and also depending upon the cost and the site location. So economizer. So economizer is also a type of preheater or we can say superheater where the flue gases coming out of the boiler is heated. An economizer extracts a part of the heat from the flue gas and it can be used for heating the feed water again, saving coal consumption and higher boiler efficiency. So by means of using the economizer, since it is used as a cyclic process, we can reduce the amount of coal which is used and also the boiler efficiency can be increased to a greater extent. Air preheater. So the function of the air preheater is to preheat the air before entering to the furnace by utilizing some of the energy left in the flue gases. So after flue gases leave the economizer, the further heat can be extracted from them and this will be increasing the plant efficiency by around 1%. So air preheater also can be linked along with the function of economizer. Next, we will going to see about the nuclear power plant or we can say the atomic power plant. So nuclear power plant also works in a similar way compared with the thermal power plant. The only difference between the thermal power plant and nuclear power plant is in the fuel what you are using. So they used to heat the water in the boiler, that is the steam generator. So here by means of a nuclear fusion process or fission process or by any nuclear reaction, we are going to generate the amount of electrical power. So inside a nuclear power station, energy is released by nuclear fission in the core of the reactor. So the main component involved in the nuclear power plant is the nuclear reactor along with the turbine. So chain reaction, uranium will be exist as an isotope. So uranium-235 we are using it. So this can be an unstable form of uranium. So when the nucleus of an atom of uranium is split, the neutrons released hit other atoms and split them into many particles. So we are calling this one as a type of a chain reaction or we can say nuclear reaction. So this is the basic construction of a nuclear reactor. In the nuclear reactor you are having the nuclear core. So nuclear core is the place where the nuclear fission process is taking place. Next important component is nothing but the moderator. So in the moderator it reduces the speed of the fast moving neutrons. So most of the moderators used will be graphite, water or heavy water. So in order to control the chain reaction, you are going for the moderator. So it will be, suppose if the neutrons released are of very high velocity. So the speed of these neutrons can be controlled and monitored by means of a moderator. So on another part is nothing but the control rods. So the control rods are used to limit the number of fuel atoms that can split. So they are made up of boron or cadmium which absorbs the neutrons. Okay. So the control rods are also used for controlling the fission reaction. Okay. Coolant. So they carry the intense heat generated.
Okay.
So mainly we are using water as the coolant and some reactors may use liquid sodium as the coolant. So depending upon the type of reactor what you are using. The fuel is normally used for nuclear fission is U-235, that is uranium-235 isotope. So and also you are having a outer shielding called as the thermal shielding. So thermal shielding is also called as radiation shielding. So that protects the people working in the nuclear power plant from any type of radiation and radiation fragments. And one type of nuclear reactor is nothing, that is water reactor is nothing but the PWR, pressurized water reactor. So heat produced due to the nuclear fission, and nuclear fission is nothing but a type of chain reaction. So the purpose of this PWR is nothing but the pressure equalizer.
Okay. to maintain a constant pressure of 14 mm per meter squared. So this enables the water to carry out the heat from the reactor in a safe way. And also you are having a coolant pump to pump the coolant water under pressure into the nuclear core. So this is the schematic diagram of the nuclear power plant involving the pressurized water reactor. So you will be having two loops, primary loop and the secondary loop. So in the primary loop you are having the main reactor pressure vessel. So inside the nuclear pressure vessel you will be having the control rods and the fuel rods. So the outer part is called as the nuclear reactor core. And water is pumped into the secondary loop, that is nothing but the steam generator. And the condensate is condensate by means of the pump. So the steam generator will be coming under the secondary loop. So steam generation is coupled to the turbine. From the turbine it goes to the condenser, that is the steam condenser. And turbine is coupled with a generator. So that will be generating the electrical power. So the only difference is that steam generator, turbine, generator and condenser will be there in the thermal power plant also. So the nuclear, in the nuclear power plant, so this additional primary loop is fixed, that is the nuclear reactor.
Okay.
So only the source is changed in the nuclear power plant.
Next.
So fuel rods. So they contain the nuclear fuel. So as I told, uranium-235 isotope you are using as the nuclear fuel. So they are surrounded by a moderator. So moderator normally are going for water or graphite.
Okay.
So in order to slow down the neutrons that are released. So to slow down the velocity of the neutrons, you are going for a moderator as a control mechanism. Control rods. So they control the rate of nuclear reaction by moving in and out of the reactor. So nuclear reaction can be controlled to a stable value by means of the control rods. So they are all moved. So the control rods will be moving in and out depending upon the reaction process. So they are made up of boron or cadmium that can absorb the neutrons. So next power plant you are going to see is the solar power plant. So solar power plant you are having the involvement of PV electricity, that is the photovoltaic electricity. This method uses the photovoltaic cell, or we can say a PV array that absorbs the direct sunlight, like the solar cells, okay, what you are using in the normal calculators. So the main purpose of the solar cell is the conversion of the sunlight, that is the light radiation, into power generation, into electricity.
Okay.
So conversion of light energy into electrical energy is taking place in the solar energy. Next one is the solar thermal electricity. So it also uses a solar collector. So solar collector is nothing but a mirrored surface. So it can normally in the form of a concave surface that reflects the sunlight into a receiver that heats up the liquid. This heated liquid is used to make steam that produces the power.
Next.
So this is the concept of a solar PV power plant. So the energy from the sunlight is falling on the solar rays. So in the solar rays you will be having millions of solar cells that will be converting the direct sunlight, or we can say light energy, into electrical energy.
Okay.
And the electrical energy is given to the domestic consumers.
Okay.
So components used in PV system is solar panel, controller, battery and inverter. So normally for storage of the power, solar power, you are going for this battery, and for conversion of power you are going for the inverter.
Next,
solar panel. So they need to convert the solar energy into electrical energy. So you will be having the solar array consisting of a positive electrode and a negative electrode. So it will be acting as a PN junction. So that is P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor sandwiched into a single cell. So this is given to the corresponding voltage controller or the voltage regulator for regulation of the voltage.
Next.
So the controller, so this is nothing but a charge controller. So it is a type of voltage regulator or voltage controller to charge the batteries and keep away the cell from any type of overcharging. So for safety purpose, you are going for a battery for storage of the corresponding power. So power inverter. So it is convert the DC to the 230 volt AC as per the need of the application. That is, if whenever you need the AC supply, AC input, you can go for this inverter.
Okay.
So this one now will be acted as an optional purpose. So these are some applications of solar energy. Solar engines from water pumping, solar water heater, solar cooker, solar dryers, solar furnaces, PV conversion, that is the by means of solar cells, solar power generation and solar distillation. So this is a site selection for the construction of a solar power plant. So the solar power plant must be constructed where there is abundance of solar radiation. So availability of solar radiation is a primary factor to be considered for site selection of the solar power plant. Then availability of land, that is a large area of land is required for this construction, and away from any type of residential construction. So accessibility from national highway, that is for transportation purpose. Distance from transmission line, local weathering concession, and land prices and future rise. Advantages. So since sun is an infinite source of energy, so you can construct the solar power plant in any remote location. So solar energy is very large, inaccessible and renewable source of energy.
Okay.
So it is more environmentally very clean and hence pollution free. So it is the best alternative for the rapid depletion of fuel cells. So disadvantage, it is available in a dilute form and is at a low potential. The intensity of solar energy on a sunny day is about 1.1 kilowatts per meter area. Solar energy is not available at night time or during the cloudy days.
Okay.
So that is one of the major drawback of this solar power plant. Next one we are going to see is the tidal power plant. So in this we are going to see introduction, tides, types of tidal power plants, major kinds of generators used in the tidal power plant. What are the advantages, disadvantages and some basic facts. So tidal power is also called as the tidal energy. So it is a form of hydropower that converts the energy of tide into some useful form of power.
Okay.
So conversion of hydro energy into electrical energy. So the first tidal power station was the Rance tidal power plant built over the period of 6 years from 1960 to 1966 at France. So it has a largest capacity of 240 megawatts installed capacity and also the world's second biggest tidal power station. So two types of tidal power plant facilities are there. One is the tidal barrages, tidal current turbines, dynamic tidal power plants. So this dynamic tidal power plants is the recent development in the tidal power generation. So first we'll see about the tidal barrage. So it will be utilizing the potential energy. So they are nothing but the typical dams built across an bay or estuary. So it consists of turbines, switch gates, embankments and ship locks. So normally it is constructed in the single basin arrangement or in a double basin arrangement. So tidal barrage is common to both single basin as well as double basin. So in the single basin system, you will be having the ebb generation, EBB. That is, during the flood, type basin is filled and sewage gates are closed, trapping the water. So gates are closed until the tides have ebbed sufficiently. And thus turbines start spinning and generating electricity. Next one is the flood generation, where the basin is filled through the turbine, which generates at a flood tide. And also last you will be having the two-way generation, where both the switch gates and turbines are closed at the same time and water is allowed to flow to the turbine. At some point the water head is insufficient for power generation. At that time the switch gates and turbines are opened and electricity is developed by this process.
Next.
Double basin system. So there are two basins, but it operates similar to the EBB generation.
Okay.
That is the single basin system. The only difference is the proportion of electricity is used to pump water into the second basin, allowing the water storage.
Okay,
so thank you. So we have seen the major types of power plants in this presentation. So thank you for listening.